We're playing Crisco Twister. The rules are simple. You need a can of Twister and some Crisco.
Couple minutes, you know, it would just, you know, wouldn't be a good thing. So they have time to clean up.
Mike, I mean, is that wireless?
We're slipping and sliding on our way to the MTV Music News.
Tell me about what you guys were doing earlier tonight. Who's that deal?
Well, Kurt thought up the Twister, and I thought up the Crisco, and everybody kind of copped out. I mean, it would have been a groovy love session. You know, we kind of sprinkled glitter on everybody and stuff, you know? And then, I don't know, the American flag got drug in it somehow. So these patriotic jocks will probably be working me over within about half an hour.
Are you guys big fans of Twister? Is that your favorite game?
It ties you up, and they're not.
So when you guys are around and things like this happen all the time, you're just like...
Trouble, yeah.
Jocks, rednecks, flag wavers, everywhere.
I've been worked over before. Bruise this heel.
Do you guys mean trouble wherever you go?
No. Nobody asked that guy what he thought.
I don't know how to know.
Oh. Well, sure, if there's some kind of kicks involved, man, I'll be there front and center, having a good time.
And obviously, you guys know these other bands?
We kind of know them, just seen them here around.
Smashing Pumpkins while we were in England last time. Then, I don't think we know LaVolta. I don't think they wanted to play Twister because we didn't know each other well enough. So, and it's kind of an intimate thing.
Yeah, they didn't want to get intimate with us. See, we're really, really intimate and personal right off
the
bat.
We're loving, open, caring, tender people.
Right. And if you want to play Crisco Twister with us, join right in, brother or sister.
But there's Twister, and then there's Crisco Twister.
And it was all vegetable Crisco, too.
Yeah.
So, what do you guys know about tonight's event?
Well, it's a big radio station schmooze-a-thon, and we came here yesterday, and
we brought the Crisco so we could grease our hands, because we've been shaking so many.
Yeah.
What do you guys think of the event?
Well, it's cool that it's a benefit. I mean, going to the homeless.
Yeah.
That's the FBI are looking at us right now.
Yeah.
That guy over there?
We're getting the evil eye. Oh. Ooh, the heat is on.
Dude, I don't know if you and TV Land can feel this, but we're being vibed really hard.
We're being vibed really bad.
We've got vibes coming in. Like,
this is not a good time to be doing an interview. Well, it's a good time to have the camera rolling, though.
In case we get beat up, we can show it in court.
It'll be like Rodney King.
Yeah. But on MTV. Wow, what a concept.
It's wonderful. It's wonderful.
It's wonderful.
It's wonderful.
Good.
Sure. Variety is a wonderful thing. Yeah.
I mean,
there's something for everybody.
Do you know Dave Kendall? Do you know Dave? Because me and Dave are tight. And at Reading, he sat and he talked to me about how he thought it was so great that so many bands could come together at one show and entertain so many people at one time. People from different races, creeds, from all over the place, you know? Dave's a great guy. I love Dave. He's a beautiful guy.
So how long have you guys been playing?
I don't know, an hour.
45 minutes.
45 minutes? That's cool. Cool by me.
It's like a normal set time, like an hour. This.
Grease,
fireworks.
Stolen explosives. Strange things we've done on stage? No, it's pretty
fun. Stage would be pretty cool.
Yeah, we should have played something safer like Crisco Monopoly.
Yeah. Crisco Tiddlywinks, Chutes and Ladders, something like that. It would have been a lot safer.
Crisco Marbles.
Crisco Marbles.
Bing!
Black Sabbath meets the Knack.
The twist to Bay City Rollers.
You guys, did you really ever buy a Bay City Rollers record?
Yeah,
yeah.
I got all of them.
I bought the single Saturday night when it came out. I was like in the fourth grade. Yeah, S-A-T-U-R-D-A-Y. Knife! Keep on.
What do you like so much about the Bay City Rollers?
They were rock and roll. Woody was my favorite. You know what Derek looks like? Derek looks like one of the new kids.
Which one?
The guy
Horse
with...
Boy?
Horse Boy.
Horse Boy.
We'll leave it at that. I'm not too familiar with the Boston music scene. What is there? Blake Babies, Dinosaur? I don't know. Every town has its own spice and flavor. I mean, it's just undeniable. Every band has something to offer some way or another.
You guys have, like, as a band, like, a certain personality, and
what's our personality?
lack of
personality. Getting vibed by really big boys right now. We gotta walk past those guys to walk out the door. I'm just gonna cold cock the biggest guy and just run. That's my philosophy.
Wait, beat feet.
I'm gonna beat feet.
Okay.
What are we about?
Deep,
what are we about? Oh, we're just crazy rock and roll band. Are we even crazy?
Not really.
I haven't had a psychiatric evaluation lately, so I can't confirm that. What are we about? We're just this rock and roll band. We play our songs, you know, and play them to the people, and if people like them, that's cool.
Can you
Well, the band started in 1987 in a small coastal town in Aberdeen, Washington, and we were just jamming in this shack, and moved out of town, started playing gigs in Seattle, made a tape, Sub Pop heard it, and the rest just keeps snowballing, I guess. Just, things just keep getting bigger and better.
Was there a special moment that you guys
I've never been conscious of anything like that. Special. I mean, Special K. I wish I took special ed in high school because I probably would have passed. Pardon me? Oh, we were the Pod Puffers. Yeah. We'd skip pep assemblies and go down to the alley, spark one up.
Spark up a conversation.
Spark up a conversation, right.
But, you know, in this subject, you have a nickname within the yearbook underneath your picture. What was underneath yours?
I hadn't taken my picture since like ninth grade.
That'd be a good reason to go skip class. When it was picture day, we'd skip and go out to the alley.
Also gave you about $10 to get your picture taken, so you'd take that and go, you know, buy things.
Looks like them gorillas cleared out.
Uh-oh.
Maybe they're waiting for us outside.
They've got the baseball bats waiting for us.
Look like a couple of refugees from a gorilla love-in.
Don't ask me. I don't know.
Oh, the song could be about anything, really, if you put your mind to it. Creativity is such a beautiful human attribute. So we just, like, leave it to the band.
And being on a major label, you can get away with just, like, senseless babble. Always. Just senseless babble. The whole thing.
What about the video? The video is kind of interesting. It looks like a high school pep assembly.
We're definitely scarred by high school. That's for sure.
Why?
High school.
Well, you graduated.
Well, did you go to high school? Yeah, I graduated. I don't know. High school is just weird. It's such an intense little society. You know, social, the cliques and the. There's a whole hierarchy of personality and popularity, and it's really intense compared to, you know, the broader spectrum of just being after, you know, after you're out of school in life. I mean, it seems like high school is a pretty focused human experience.
A lot of people who just like our band came down. No, those were hired prostitutes and tattoo artists.
No, I was just gonna say that we played a show a couple nights before, and we invited everyone down to come down and just watch us do the video, and I don't know if they knew what to expect. So like 300 kids showed up and just hung out. It was pretty cool.
So what are you guys doing now?
Whiskey 7.
What are we doing now? We're touring. We're going to be on tour for 7 weeks around the United States. We have 5 days off, and we're going to go do 4 weeks in Europe. And sure, we love going around, meeting people, getting vibed by a bunch of geeks. Bizarre thing that's happened to me
on this tour.
On this tour. Well, this tour just started. So well, I mean, there's so many. It's a pretty weird thing to be traveling and to be in this like mind-altered situation every night. And so crazy things happen. I mean, it's not that crazy. We're not like total craziness, but you know, situations do arise. I wish we were the type of band that would sleep all the time, but it's something possesses us to go on. I don't know what's typical. Yeah, we even when we're at home, we usually get together and
just go out and have some drinks and hang out with our friends in like Seattle or Tacoma or Olympia and have a good time.
What do we do for fun?
Probably drink. Or go to the Rendezvous on 2nd Avenue.
You bowl,
skinny dipping, basket weaving,
decorating, gun cleaning.
Gun cleaning, yeah.
Cake decorating.
Sub-pop? Yeah, sub-pop was a good experience. You gotta think, you know, this is in the I'm okay, you're okay vein of thinking, but every experience is a good experience because it was an experience. That's the key to happiness in life, my friends. Ann Arbor, Michigan.
Yeah.
Rocks. Because those people rock there. They really rock. They're a good crowd. Italy is really fun to play. England. I mean, we've been to a lot of places where we've had it. You can't name them. You know, we could always name the bad shows, but it's hard to name the good shows because it's a good time.
What makes an audience really great? What really makes it fun?
It's a vibe, you know? Since we are being vibed, we are pretty sensitive to vibes, right? And it's just a cool vibe. Everybody's having fun and nothing can go wrong. It's just beautiful.
Did you guys come back and
do what? This show?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Wave of mutilation?
Yeah, we do anything. If you set it up, we'll do it. That's our motto.
All right. I just have a couple questions for some other shows. One of them is here in Rock. What do you guys think is the biggest event that happened in music last year?
Last year? An event, or do you mean just like music in general? Oh, the Breeders album. Because it's the best album that happened in the last year, easily. It's just, I can't explain it. It's just one of the best albums I've ever heard in my life, and it moves me.
I think that would definitely have to be Shona Knife coming to America.
Oh,
again. Shona Knife, man, coming to America. It's like Beatles coming to America for the first time. It's amazing. It's a frenzy.
I don't know, musically I've had my personal high points. I just can't, like on a collective, I just can't come up with an answer. Something big that came important within the last year, Gorky Park, something big that happened. New Sonic Youth record. That was good. Goo Rock, my socks off. And that was personal, you know.
What kind of music do you guys listen to?
Sonic Youth, Melvins.
Mudhoney.
Shonen Knife.
Breeders. I don't know, pretty much everything we've already mentioned.
Yeah, Vaseline's, there's a lot of bands. I can't think right now, really. My mind's kind of preoccupied.
So is there anything you guys are looking forward to tonight?
About tonight's show? No, I think we just look forward to playing a good show, hopefully a good show. And we won't be shot on stage or anything like that.
See you guys do some IGs.
I'm looking forward to walking out that door in one piece. Oh. What do we say? This is
Nirvana.
We are Nirvana. And this is the week in rock.
Yo!
Yeah.
Yeah. I must say.
Oh.
Hey, all you people staying up late on a Sunday night. Obviously, you're not working. Slack off. You don't need your job. Don't say yes, sir, yes, ma'am. Say cram it. Don't show up tomorrow. Call in sick. And this is Nirvana, and you're watching
120 minutes
on
MTV.
MTV.
One more.
Oh.
Asia?
Peace, MTV Asia.
Peace, Asia.
This is Nirvana. And you're watching MTV. Asia. What was the big Asia?
Thank you. check, check.
Thank you.
Thank you. tomorrow. Our record's being released tomorrow, so you want you can buy it. We're going to play a show tomorrow. All ages and actions. So everybody here with fake IDs, don't sweat it, because you can get it in hassle-free tomorrow night.
Let me take a ride, hurt yourself. Thank you.